she told me her what a jewelry designer, so I was just surprised for what is that.
Jewelry hides selling like hotcakes.
She's living her dream right now, you know?
Koketso Mohlala, I'm 26 years of age. I'm from Soshanguve. I'm a jewelry designer and manufacturer. I own Ditsala Designs and Creations.
Ke holetse go stembatere go amanskrala and ke hurile ke lengwanolo o mo creative, o mo confident, I could say overconfident because Hevare dance, I was there. Koleraton primary school. Hevare drama, I was there.
Heke ho lela go stembatere o itse khoneng ya line ya go hae ne ba etsa di beats. Hentse ke bona go kole a etsa di beats. I fell in love with them. And then ebe ke mutsa hore o di etsa byang amponta. And then ebe ke starta ho etsa jewelry, ke etsa ring ya di beats, ke berekisa khetsi ya dinamune.
She will make a ring a yetse ka matsoho then o kre a ya pere, o kre a rena matshwara a rapetse.
And then that's where ko hae ba boneng hore ai o maybe ke na a tsileng mo family like o creative.
No mona a rata go draw di ring and then rata hape le di magazine tsa manyalo like tsa stands wedding di catalog tsa teng like ne le motho le re na rata go cut a le di cut and paste.
This other day ne ke bohetse TV SABC 3 isidingo. Ebe ke bona persons a drawa barki jewelry designer and then I saw drawings of jewelry. I was like, okay, that's unique. I want to be like him.
Hi high school. Ebe ke motore o batla go nna eng. So she told me hore o batla nna go nna jewelry designer. So I was just surprised hore what is that because I never heard about it. Then ebe an tlhalosetsa gore ke nyako ira di-ring, jewelry, whatever. So ebe ke re Koketso nna eo a ke tlhaloganye. So are you saying to me gore o nyako bereka ona mmereko mo bjaono a re eng mama?
Mama a re yo nna zanka ka utlwa motho mo gae a re ena o irile jewelry design ke dilo mantseo. Why o sa nyako tshwana le bana ba bangwe o ire di-law, o ire medicine and IT. And then I was like, okay, re ke mo thabise as ngwana o mongwe le mongwe, you know, o batla go thabisa batswadi ba gago. Ebe ke etsa IT.
Koketso and I met in 2008 ko college-ing. We were studying IT. Koketso was a happy man. She was always complaining about everything in the lecturers and everything.
It was very hard. At the end, ebe ke fetsa.
Ebe re mama nna a ke boela hapa hape ko ke batla etsa jewelry design.
Then ebe ke find out ka Atreshville Jewelry Project and they told me hore I was going to be on a learnership. So I was like, oh, that's a bonus. So I'm going to study jewelry design and I don't have to pay.
So then ebe ke no, it's okay, I will support you because ne ke feel hore I have to support her of which he ke mo hapeletsa hore I say ntwe nna ke batlang a se carry ya ka kya hae.
I don't know what happened to her. All of a sudden she started supporting me.
So I registered at college for jewelry design. I remember the first month, I was so surprised at actually some of the things studied in college. I remember the first time I cried because I feel like why is it the first day I ate? Because I feel like I'm going to do it because I'm going to do it and I'm going to do it.
I studied there for 3 years. Then after 3 years, I graduated. When I was graduating, like, you know, when they call out people's names for awards and all that, and I'm just there relaxing, you know, and then they said, Koketso Mohlala, best design student.
I had something, it's a funny feeling, like, I don't believe, is it my daughter? Like, when they called me on stage, I couldn't even hold her. I was, like, shivering, like, crying and crying, but all above all, I thank God.
It was an emotional day, and when I was on stage, I was like, I felt, hore, you know what, ke fitlhile ko ne ke batlang go fitla.
Social life ya Koketso e tlhakatlhakane in a way. Because even if we went out for the drinks or let's meet for lunch or what, she would bring case ya ya ditsala.
After graduating, I stayed home for a couple of months, and they called me, they said, come here, come take a job as a junior trainer.
So that's when she started making money, but like, nearly salary. So we were like, mama, now I can't work for somebody. I want to work for my own, and then I want to own my own business.
That's when I started Ditsala Designs and Creations.
But I started understanding her, if I don't give her the full support, you're going to make it, my girl. But she's I can see she's going somewhere.
The reason why I call my company Ditsala Designs is because I regard everybody who supports me as my friend. You know, when you need money, when you don't have food, your friend will always have your back. So by buying my jewelry, you're putting food on my table. Most of my designs are inspired by African pieces, old traditional pieces, and African stories and everyday lifestyle.
With my time spent with Dominic, him and I had worked with Koketso in trying to determine, or letting her rather understand that she needs to think about what kind of need there is in the market for her product.
I used to do commercial pieces, but then I was like, why am I dwelling into that? Because already there's a market for commercial jewelry. Why don't I do something unique, something different, something that will set me apart from other jewelry designers? Today I'm gonna be making love stud earrings. I'm gonna start with melting the silver, and then after that, I'm gonna roll it. And then after rolling it, I'm gonna pull it to turn it into wire. And then I'm gonna bend it to make the love word. And then I'm gonna turn it into an earring. Now that it's round, I can start making the earrings. Jewelry design is a form of art that enables one to think out of the box. Actually, I always say, I don't think out of the box. I was never in the box. It enables you to see something in a different way. Like everything you see it as jewelry. Like I would be walking, you know, and I'll see a gate and then I'll think, you know, those patterns, I wanna use them as jewelry. What can I do with them? Now I'm gonna anneal the wire to make it soft and easy to bend. You know, when you say you're a jewelry designer, people think, well, yo, that's the fanciest job. And actually, if they could see what we go through here, like my nails are not like everybody's nails. Like, I don't want to do handshakes because my nails are scratchy, you know, they're very dirty and all that.
designer, being a jewelry designer is a calling. When you choose to be a designer, you get married into this career. Like, you won't have a life.
Now I'm gonna put the back pins on the love words so that they can be earrings.
You know, Kokasi, when you say kira jewelry, hey, but Kokasi wa negative. You know, mototo waza horo walwala. We na wira ring eo, musa tsadi chant.
So the most challenging thing is getting support.
And it's so sad, hore, people wanna support the well-known brands. You know, it's very sad that most of our minerals, di tlhaga mo South Africa, they go out, but then they come back as Hong Kong, se di ropilweng. They don't come back as 100%.
Why not buy selo se se irileng ke nna, ke se rekile ka mineral, ke se irile ka minerale wa mo hae.
So I'm sure hore, the quality is also pure.
Now I'm gonna polish the earrings using the polishing brush and the hanging motor and a polish. I'm gonna put them in the ultrasonic cleaner.
Every time I work with a piece of jewelry, I get attached to it. Like, if client tempota hore ka engage, ko belong ketse an engagement ring. You know, I'm gonna have a relationship to it. Even though ke tlo gobala hantsi ke yetsa, but I'm still gonna love it. That's why I always say, you know, it's better to buy handmade products because they have sentimental value, unlike a piece that's mass produced.
Now I'm done. As you can see, they are all lovely and glamorous. When you see a person wearing them, you'll think that it's easy to make them, but then the work that goes into making this and the way our hands are dirty and we get hurt, it's not easy.
When I started Ditsala, I was very broke, but early this year, I went to Design Indaba. And got Design Indaba, as people were loving my things, I managed to meet buyers, international buyers, people who buy in bulk.
I used to struggle a lot for because I can't keep it. But I'll be lying. I'm struggling. I'll be lying, to be quite honest too. I'll be lying.
I'm starting to be that girl who half it higher. Mama, I decided to regular TV.
I'm supplying a store in Holland, and I got Holland through Design Indaba. I'm also supplying a store called O.R. Tambo.
Jewellery is selling like hotcakes. She supplied jewellery for Wanda Baloyi, Bucie. Now she's supplying for Mini Dlamini.
Koketso was showing tremendous growth and a lot of innovation in her designs. I mean, fundamentally, she's a designer first before she's a businesswoman.
Right now, I have a new client that's Rory Sang from Musat.
Right now, I'm working on Rory Sang's ring. So first, what I do is to get a clear picture of the kind of person she is, her style, so that when I make the ring, I know what I'm working with. And as I can see here, I think she would love something very unique.
I'm very excited because, you know, every time you meet a new client, you know, hurry, if I deliver a good job, I'm gonna get more clients through her. I'm very excited.
Right now I'm gonna start cutting the Africa shape and her name. I'm gonna use a saw frame and a saw blade.
now I'm gonna solder everything together on both pieces. Must make sure that it's where I want it to be. I'm gonna use oxygen and gas. Now, Rory and Africa are perfectly joined together. Now, I must make a ring, a shank, that's gonna go on the finger. Because I don't know Rory's finger size, I'm gonna make the ring adjustable so that she can adjust it. In the water. I'm gonna put it in the tumbler so that it can be clean. And then I'm gonna roll it for 5 to 10 minutes. And polish it. I'm gonna start with a rough mop. And then after the rough one, I must use a smooth one so that it can shine. I'm gonna leave it here for 3 minutes. Now I'm done. I'm gonna give it to Rorisang. I hope she's gonna love it.
Hi, Koketso.
Hi.
Okay.
Good thing.
Rorisang is on her way. She'll only be a few minutes, ne?
So oh, okay.
Please take a seat. Reclaim my mela just now.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Hello.
Hi.
Coco.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good.
Together.
Yeah.
Lovely to meet you. Nice finally. I've been talking to you. How are you doing? So what do you have in store for me?
I have beautiful jewelry pieces.
Okay.
Yeah. What are you going to be wearing?
I'm going for navy blue. Trying to go do the warm.
I can do with that.
You could do that.
Yeah.
To help you pack us. Let me see that. Oh, this is nice.
No, if this is gonna.
Oh, wow. So you make these from scratch?
Yes.
That is amazing. Oh, wow.
I'll do it myself.
This is beautiful.
Oh, okay, I've got something specially made for you.
This is, you know, funny enough, I was looking at these earrings.
And they go with the...
Is this a ring?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Let's, and I love big rings, so you got it spot on. Oh my gosh, that has my name on it.
Yes.
That is gonna be like the coolest thing ever. Oh my gosh.
I got a royal ring.
Two. And then once I've changed, we'll see. Let me go change, actually.
Okay.
All right, but I want to keep my ring.
All right.
Because I feel like it's And then we'll go with those ones.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Sorry, let's do this, man.
Yes.
Are you good?
I'm happy.
All right, okay. Nice jewelry that you have there.
Whatever let's you do, go. Get this.
Definitely.
Thank you again.
Give me attitude.
Attitude?
Yeah.
So, Rubile, I told her I like big, chunky rings. And I like, because you see, like, the bigger they are, the better for me. Because attention. And I think the biggest surprise was I was expecting a ring, but the big surprise was that my name was on it. So that was a lovely surprise from her. I will really treasure this. This was a lovely surprise. A beautiful piece, even if it didn't have my name on it, it sincerely is. The texture, the feeling of it, it's got your rough and smooths on it. The gold is a nice solid gold.
When I gave it to her, like, the look on her face was overwhelming because I didn't know whether she's gonna love it or not. But like, khasno ay rata. I'm happy that she's impressed, and I hope for her she's gonna bring me more customers.
Okay, Amy, with your right hand, play around with the necklace a bit.
I don't know what to do.
Nice. Okay, just do your thing. And then, okay, turn all the way to your left.
Left.
Okay, flick your hair over a bit. Very nice. Okay. A few more of the earrings and this. Nice. Good.
So she's been doing her business for a year and a half, and it's only amazing to see in a year and a half. With the business, the work that she's done already. I can only imagine what her business is going to look like in 5 years and even the next 2 years. So, and that maybe one day she doesn't get too famous enough to give me or to dress me with her jewelry one day. I feel like I'll be competing with Beyonce one day, you know. But please give me jewelry, not Beyonce.
You know, every time when I pray, I pray for Mudimu Ahurise Ditsala Designs. Ibe a brand that will be known to the whole world.
Kebana future Koketso ele very bright, and Nagari Jewellery tsa hae ele very bright and ndile unique.
Her energy is endless for this. She's the right person with the right passion doing the right thing. And she's living her dream right now, you know? And for us to have enabled that, I mean, for Dominic and I to have enabled that, that's really special, and that is a milestone within itself.
And last year, I started seeing myself, you know, now I'm here. But then now I can see Hore, I'm definitely getting there. Come next year, this time, Ditsala will be places.